In Flash, you don't always have to create your artwork directly in the program. You can actually create it with outside programs such as Photoshop and Illustrator. Now, fair warning, Flash is a vector program. As with all animation, it's not meant to be photoreal. And so it tends to prefer Adobe Illustrator files, which creates vector files, rather than Photoshop. But that doesn't mean that you can't import Photoshop. But just be aware that bitmap photos or raster photos have a larger file size and they could bog down your project. And it's just not something that is going to show up beautiful, perfect, crystal clear quality in your Flash program. So I'm going to show you how to create or import Illustrator and Photoshop files. Let's start with Illustrator. We'll go to File, Import, and you can either choose to import directly to the stage if you're going to work on it right now, or you can import to the library. I always like to import to the library because I don't like it to interfere with whatever I might have happening on my stage. So I'll choose Import to Library, and I'll choose my artsupplies.ai. And I can go ahead and hold the control key on my keyboard and click this little toggle, and that's going to give me this little shortcut menu to collapse all. And now this is showing up as all of the different art supplies. Now they're already named and they're showing up as individual items, and that's because when I put this in Illustrator, I made sure that they were in all on their own separate layers, and they all had specific names. So make sure that your Illustrator and your Photoshop file is as organized as you can possibly make it, so it's a lot easier when you import into Flash. Now, there's a lot of different options that you have for both importing Illustrator and Photoshop files, and it's not going to hurt if you open up a new document and just keep trying to import the same file over and over again to see what settings do what things. So for instance, let's say I wanted to change this to keyframes. Let's see what happens when I hit OK. It's going to import that file, and now all of a sudden I have this AI file, but it's actually a movie clip. So I'll go ahead and move it up here, and we'll zoom out to see what's happening with this. And as with all movie clips, I can double click inside and see what happened. And it looks like it actually has each of the paint supplies or art supplies on a frame by frame animation. So it did in fact pull it in as keyframes. Now, if you didn't want to have that happen, you could delete this movie clip, or you could also drag this to the library and convert it to whatever type of symbol you want and give it a name. But there are easier ways to do this. So I'm going to go ahead and delete that movie clip and re-import and choose a different setting. So let's try one more experiment. I'll right-click and do Collapse All. And from here, I'll do Flash Layers. So let's see what happens when I do that. So now I have a graphic symbol, and I can pull it on there. And again, with all symbols, you can double click to see what's happening inside, and it doesn't look like I have flash layers. It's just my regular layer one, and then I have this graphic symbol. So let's double click, and now all of a sudden I can see within that internal timeline for that graphic symbol, all of the different supplies are on their own layer, and they took the same name that I gave them in the layers in Illustrator. So that's pretty cool. But I don't think I like that one either. So I'll go ahead and delete that, and this is the one that I use most often where I just convert everything that comes into a movie clip. So I'll do Fit in Window and Import to Library. Choose it again. Now I don't want to import all of these because that'll take a long time. So let's just say I want the spray paint and the paint palette and the paint tubes. So you can import them as a bitmap. Again, it's going to be pretty pixelated because Flash doesn't like bitmap files, so instead I'm going to create this as a movie clip and give it a name. So this one will do MC Spray Paint. Oops. And then I'll click on the paint palette, MC Palette. And I'm not sure if you really call these tubes. I call them tubes. So MC Tubes. All right. So it's not going to bring any of the other stuff in. Let's click OK. And all of a sudden we have this graphic symbol, and it only has the three paint supplies in it. So if I double click inside, you can see that there are their own layer. But now, if I click in this folder, each of my symbols has their own folder, and now I can drag them into my project one by one. So let's go ahead and leave that there, and let's do the paint tubes up here, and I can mess with all this stuff, make it smaller. And there we go. So those look really good because they are in fact vector graphics, and that's what Flash likes. So let's see what happens when we try to import a Flash or a Photoshop file, which is bitmap or raster graphics. So I'll go to File and Import to Library, and I'll choose this artvariety.psd. And let's go ahead and look at what this looks like in Photoshop. I have a background that I was just using to see what it would look like on a dark background, but I've turned off both of those layers because I don't need the white one and I don't need the dark one. I want to be able to decide what that should look like in Flash. And then I have the paint splatter, tattoo artist, and graffiti pictures, but I've also added a border to each one and a drop shadow. Now it's important to note that with inside Flash, you can take those photos and add strokes and you can add drop shadows. So you don't necessarily have to do them in the Photoshop program, but I just wanted to show you a feature, and it's kind of a weird feature and I've never used it, but at least I'll show you this feature that can happen if you add styles to layers in Photoshop before you import. So now when I come back to the import dialog box, it's gonna tell me all the layers that were in that Photoshop file, and I can convert them to Flash layers or keyframes. And by checking each one, I can choose what I want. So for the graffiti artist and tattoo and paint, they're all going to come in as bitmap images, or I can have them come in as a movie clip layer. So let's say for the paint splatter, I want to call this MC paint splatter. And let me give you a couple of, let's see, for the tattoo artist, we'll do bitmap image with editable layer styles. It's automatically going to be a movie clip, so I'll call this MC Tattoo. And for the graffiti artist, we're going to change this compression to lossless. So that means it's not really going to compress, it's not going to lose any data when it compresses. So if I do calculate bitmap size, it's going to be 123K, when if it was lossy, it would actually be 14.8K. So this would be great for load times for my project, and you have to balance quality with load time. So I'll change this back to lossless so you can see the quality of that. And I think all of our experiments for those three layers are good. So let's see what it looks like. So it's going to pull it in, and again, it's going to give us a graphic symbol that has all three, and then each of them has their own folder that they can be in. So let's pull this graffiti image in. Now that image, you're going to see it is a little bit pixelated because again, Flash is not, you know, it's not meant for, again, raster or bitmap graphics, but it is pretty good, and it brought in my stroke and it brought in my drop shadow. So let's see what happened with the tattoo artist. This one is lossy, so it did have compression, so it is a smaller file size. And if I double click inside of it, you can see that it separated the drop shadow from the image itself. So that way you can still edit that drop shadow, or you can get rid of it if you didn't want that drop shadow on your picture. Now for the paint splatter, I can't remember what settings, I already forgot what settings we did for that one. Oh, it was just gonna be a movie clip. So now all of these are created as movie clips and you didn't have to take that extra time and step. So when it comes to importing graphics, just play around with a couple of settings in a project you don't care about. And also be aware that if you go into the program preferences, you should be able to go to the Photoshop file importer and the AI file importer. And this is where you can set the settings so that you don't, if you have a certain way you do things and you're doing it all the time, hopefully this will save you time so you're not always having to click on settings every time you import something.